What's up, guys? And welcome back to my channel. Guys, as my custom is on my channel, every time I make a video, I always like to review 10 strange things you find in Kabwe, just like I do everywhere I go. So among the 10 strange things I found in Kabwe, guys, number one, it's a beautiful place known as Kabwe, guys. I don't know whether it is because of the pandemic, a train in this place, there is a commuter train. There is a train that operates here, coming from the copper belt, goes all the way to Livingstone. But the strange thing is that this train only passes once a week on Saturdays, 2 a.m. on Saturdays, going to Lusaka. It goes beyond anywhere up to Livingstone. So that is the strange thing, number one. I expected it to pass more often. And then I also wanted to use it because I just wanted to experience it, guys. I just wanted to have an experience of the train ride and make a video for you. But 02, and then on Saturday, I couldn't make it, guys. Number two strange things, guys. This place, there is a mine which was defunct years ago, and I mean years. Maybe more than 30 years ago, guys. The mine, the minerals are still there. Zinc, lead, I don't know the other one. There is a mine here, and minerals are still there. But guys, the mine doesn't operate at all. No functioning. The mine doesn't function. There is somebody who is just like, you know, keeping up, but there's no activity. Stand by for number three. Number three strange thing, guys. Check out the water I've bought. Check how much on a hot day. One kwacha, guys. Another strange thing. Very good, guys. Oh, some copyright music here. Just this, guys. For one kwacha. Yes, it means if you can't afford expensive water, guys, they refill like this. You buy it for one kwacha. Yes. Only one kwacha, guys, and it is solid, the same water they just refill. Very simple life. And number fourth reason, strange thing about this beautiful place, guys, is as I'm walking here again, you can see this tree, the popular Mukuyu tree, guys, in Kabwe, the more than 100 years old popular tree in Kabwe. Is just one of those strange things. Comment down below if you know any other. No wonder it has even been recognized as a national monument for our country. Just this tree, guys, as you can see it, the Mukuyu tree or the fig tree here in Kabwe. It's one of the strange things, guys. Tell me if it's not strange. A tree which is more than 100 years, and then it has been preserved. People are so patriotic, they have not cut down the tree. Number five, taxis here. Taxis here, they are extremely cheap. Too many taxis which I saw, and then taxis are also affordable. That to me was very surprising, and it was encouraging. So many places you want to go to, you just hear it's 8 kwacha, you hear 7 kwacha, things like that. So to me, that was a surprise. The other surprising thing was also, there were also, I know even in Lusaka it happens, there are a lot of unregistered taxis. When I say unregistered, I don't mean they have a number plate, but they don't have a fleet number. find that they just possess a black number. And there were points where I sat down, even the police would still come and wait for a taxi to jump on an unregistered taxi. Oh, these are taxis we call pirate taxi. So to me, that was strange. Even police would even jump on those same unregistered taxis, which we call like pirate taxis. So to me, that was strange. Although I appreciated the fact that taxis in Kabwe, taxis are really affordable. The seventh strange thing I found in Kabwe is that Kabwe happens to have houses, even very old houses. You find that they are not even fenced. I went into places like the High Ridge residential area. I went to places like Nkrumah extension on Nkrumah East. I went to places like Luangwa in Kabwe. These are some of the places where I went to. What surprised me was that accommodation, their houses, there are a lot of houses which are not even fenced off with a wall fence like our culture is. I don't know whether even in other countries, but in Zambia, when someone builds a house, they automatically like put a wall fence. Some of these houses have been around like for more than 50 years. And you discover that they don't even, they may have a small fence or a hedge, just flowers or thin wire. They don't mind about the offense. What does that tell you? So that may connect us to maybe number 8, or the same way I would say number 7. So in Kabwe, there is quite very good security. There is less crime. Their criminal activities are very rare. Burglars are not that common, although I heard a gentleman who was saying, you know, burglars are rarely in this place, but if you hear there is burglary taking place, most of the time it is when, because in Kabwe, that is where you find the Mkoveko maximum prison. So when they release some inmates there, then people suddenly experience some burglars, and then they will know it is because of the new inmates. A few inmates who were released and have been infused in the community. Yes. But 8th strange thing I found in Kabwe is that Kabwe, so apart from the mines, which I said are defunct, the other surprising thing was that in Kabwe, what surprised me was there is also the Mulungushi textile. There is a textile there as well. I think it has been government not coming or finding an investor, or government putting in recapitalizing the industry. There is a big industry which can provide employment to a lot of people, especially the youths, but the industry is also as well. When you check the Mulungushi textile, I remember passing through that place, it is like a ghost industry. It is a ghost. It doesn't even like work. So that is so strange. It's not people's fault. This has been governments. The previous governments have never really like taken advantage. We are hoping the new government, which is here, which has just stepped in, it will do something about it. Number 9, well, I'm Bemba myself. I found Kabwe to have a lot of Bemba. Kabwe is in Central Province. It will surprise you how big, because they were just a few kilometers from Lusaka, within 100 kilometers, because Lusaka Kabwe, 138 kilometers. When you leave Kabwe, just in between the Kabwe, so it is just about how languages change. Within Lusaka, there is a lot of Nyanja, but within the 138 kilometers between Lusaka and Kabwe, in between, there is Lenje speaking. It is also in Central Province. The same Central Province, you just move a little bit, you are in Kabwe, where there is a lot of Bemba. How places change, how the language just like twists. The same Central Province is where you find there's Mumbwa. Of course, you find there's a lot of Sala, a lot of Ila. Ila zini tezi tezi, you find there is a lot of lozi, there is donga, there is so too many languages in one province. So it, to me, that is also a strange thing, but I kind of like it. I've been to Itezi Tezi and found that they speak Tonga, they speak Ila, they speak a lot of, there is a lot of Kalobales in Itezi Tezi, which is part of Central Province. So it also surprised me that how smaller places. Then when you go beyond Kabwe, you begin to discover there are things like Lalas, typical Bembas now in the, as you start going towards the north. So strange thing. Everyone in Kabwe, if you don't speak Bemba, you will be out of place. Just like the way I went to Chipata, where I found Chewa, Nsenga, and Ngoni spoken. I was in Mongu, where there is typical Lozi. If you don't speak Lozi, you are out of place. The same thing, if you are in Kabwe, you don't speak Bemba, they will know you are not a Kabwe, you are not from Kabwe. So in Kabwe, Bemba speaking, that is one of the strange things, so which I learned while traveling. But then I also found, in spite of the hardships and everything, I discovered people in Kabwe are so enterprising. They are hard workers in Kabwe, even early in the morning. There are a lot of farmers who work around. They come from the farms, they'll bring their produce to the market. They are always trying their best. You find that you find a lot of vegetables, a lot of fruits. You find that people are running small kiosks. People are running small restaurants. There are people who are doing some mobile money. A lot of stuff. I saw that people in Kabwe, I mean, in spite of the few hardships, things may not be easy, but people are also very, very enterprising. Those are my 10 strange things I found in Kabwe. Another strange thing I found in Kabwe, but it was encouraging to me, is that in Kabwe I discovered there is a lot of spiritual revival. So if you are a Christian, there is a lot of Christianity in Kabwe. People in Kabwe, I think in Zambia, of the many places I've been, or where I've lived, or where I've traveled to, in Kabwe, people take God seriously. I found spiritual revival in Kabwe. To me, that was very, very encouraging, which I found. People of Kabwe love God. There are a lot of churches, different types of churches. So in short, church, Christianity is really concentrated in Kabwe. And to me, that was encouraging. I need to travel to many places, I don't know which destinations I need to go next. I'm believing God. If you want to sponsor any of my trips, please check my WhatsApp. As you open Traveltainment, you can see my WhatsApp number. Contact me. How you may support my journey? Or maybe when I'm vlogging on the street, one of the things I struggle most is that my camera sometimes stabilization. I need a DJI action camera. So whatever happens, if you can't help me, please watch my videos. That is part of sponsoring me. Maybe in the near future, I'll be able to afford the camera. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, turn on bell notification, give this video a thumbs up, drop a comment as well. I'll see you in my next video. Peace.